Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Ksenia and I make videos for people who are going through the family immigration process. In today's video, I will show you how to change your address with USCIS. Before I show you how to actually change your address, I want you to be aware of the following things. Firstly, you can only change the address in your USCIS account if you already filed a case with USCIS. If you do not have an active case with USCIS, you won't be able to change the address. Next, you must change your address and notify USCIS within 10 days of moving. And be careful when changing your address before you apply for naturalization. If after moving, your USCIS service district or jurisdiction changes, you'll have to wait 3 months before becoming eligible to file your N-400 application. And finally, if your case is currently at the NVC stage, then you must submit an address change request using the Department of State's public inquiry form rather than the USCIS site. So now that you know these important things, let me show you how to actually change your address. First, go to the USCIS.gov site and sign in to your USCIS account. And once you sign in, you can go to My USCIS and it will take you to your USCIS account, as you can see. Next, click on My Account. And you can either choose profile or change your address. So let's click on profile. It will take us to our profile information. And here you will be able to see what cases you have currently pending. So we have an N-400 case, for example, and we also have an I-751 case pending. So either one of those are cases that have not yet been approved. Let's select our N-400 case. And here, if we scroll down, you'll be able to see all the details of our case. Also, your current contact information that USCIS has on file. And if you would like to change your address, again, like we did before, you can do it from the homepage right away, or you can click this link that says submit a change of address request. So let's click that. And it will take us to the change your address form. So carefully read all the statements here. So if you scroll down, please read the following disclosures. You need to complete your request in one session. It will not save if you are inactive for a certain period of time, blah, blah, blah. So now let's click on the change my address. So step one, confirm your name and date of birth. A lot of the times this information will already be filled in for you and click next. Step two, it will ask you for your new address. So if we scroll down, it'll ask you for your new physical address. They'll also ask you if your new physical address is the same as your mailing address. So if we click yes, we can proceed. But if we click no, it will ask you to provide your new mailing address. But let's just, for the sake of us, we're gonna say that we live and receive mail at the same address. Click next. Step three, confirm your immigration information. Your A number should already be typed in and your case information. This is important. You are going to have a case number already typed in here, current active case that you have. But if you have more than one applications pending, such as, for example, in our case, it was I-751 removal of conditions and an N-400 case, click to add a new receipt number and type in the new receipt number so that you have two receipt numbers or however many current pending applications you have. Click next. And the final step is review your request. Make sure that all of this information is correct. Your new physical and mailing address, A number, and here you can see the two receipt numbers that we submitted. And make sure that you add all the pending receipt numbers that you have. Click this button to certify and click submit. Once you submit, it will take you to a summary of your submissions and the status will say submitted. And eventually you want your status to say address changed. If you scroll down, you'll be able to see what each status description says. As you can see, it is a fairly simple and quick process. So I hope that you found this video useful. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And I hope to see you guys in my next videos. Bye.